Hey Gemini, it's me Stormy, and here is your horoscope for February 2020. And Gemini, as you can see, new board, new layout, all kinds of good new stuff. So bear with me while I'm learning, but I will get you informed on what's happening in our cosmic weather sphere for February 2020. Now Geminis, what I want you to keep in mind, one of the things that's going to happen as we're moving into February, if you can look and you see that the upper part of the chart, so the southern hemisphere, depending on where you're at, the top part of the chart, this is what we call the day side of the chart, is still very busy. It's very, very heavy. So many of the influences that you saw traveling through January of 2020 will still be in place. This still makes it an excellent, excellent career peak time for you. And it means that handling things very much so outside, in public, right? That's where your benefit is going to be. This is where the music's at. You want to dance where the music is playing, and it's very much so in public and above the horizon line. And in fact, if you look and you can see, all of the planets that we have, except for the moon, are above your horizon line. So that is a telltale piece of information for us to understand that producing outwardly is where there's going to be a fair amount of success, okay? Now this month we've also got Mercury, your ruling planet, heading into retrograde in the energy of Pisces, where he's already in fall. So this may be a little bit more of a confusing retrograde than some of them necessarily are, but I think it is totally survivable as well. All right, Gemini, let's jump in here and talk about what's happening on the weatherscape, okay? So right at the beginning of the month, we're going to see Mercury, your ruling planet, our planet of communication, of the mind, of details. It's very business savvy. He's going to hit the road and come out of the energy of Aquarius and move into the energy of Pisces. Now, Mercury in Pisces is in a state that we call fall, which means he is not at full power here, right? Mercury likes facts, he likes details, he likes to be concise, and he likes to be clear. In the energy of Pisces, the planet has to get on board acting like the sign, doing things the way that the sign does. So we take our most fact-specific energy, and we put it in a very vague energy of Pisces that likes the feelings, the emotions, the maybes, the in-between the worlds. It's very watery. So Mercury is trying to think clearly through water. So not exactly comfortable. This is not a strong position for him. But just because a planet is in fall doesn't mean they're completely ineffective, right? So where are your strengths with this energy? First of all, this Mercury in Pisces movement is going to move into your 10th house, so your midheaven. This is career, right? This is your soul level calling. This is what you're doing in public. This is what you're known for in your community, what you're known for in general. Are you single? Are you married? What are you known as, and what are you doing in a very public sphere? Because that's what this house is all about. So up here in this 10th house, this particular movement tells me that one of the strengths you're going to have with Mercury in this placement is going to be to trust your intuition. Trust your intuition, make those vision boards about what you want going forward, or make your vision board about how you'd like to make more solid or more creative or more inventive, more surrendered in this particular area of your life. Remember, logic is not your strongest ticket this month. It's just not going to be. So you're going to have to come to trust your intuition. Be empathetic with the people that you're working with and interacting with. If you're a parent, are you using empathy with your children, with your friends? If you own a business, right? This is a business sector. Are you listening? Are you listening empathetically to what's happening? Are you sharing the truth of what's happening for you so that people can listen with empathy to you as well? That's going to be a very big part of what you're going to do with Mercury in Pisces, okay? On the 7th, we've got Venus coming out of this noise, and she's going to hit the road and move over here into the energy of Aries. Now, this is going to light up your 11th house. Now, Venus in Aries, she's not also particularly comfortable in this placement either, because Venus is about the us. She wants everybody to have a little something good, bring harmony, diplomacy, right? In the relationship, everybody's getting some juicy, not just me, but Aries is about me, right? So Venus moves into Aries, and the planet has to act like the sign. So one of the things that can happen with Venus in Aries, especially here in the 11th house, and your 11th house is friendships, groupings, that's you at the gym, social things, maybe you're social online, or maybe you attend a social gathering, a book club or something, your ambitions, these things where you meet at a social level. Venus in Aries here, you could instantly have a friend that was just a friend at noon, and by 3, they are not a friend anymore because y'all have been naked, right? Like, Aries, Venus in Aries is very impulsive. I have this placement. I can tell you all about it. So you have to be mindful that love at first sight, impulsivity, little flings could come out of this area as well. Another thing to consider, though, the passion and the fire that Venus in Aries does live with is at your love and your relationships, at your money, at your value. That Aries energy is going to drive you forward and say, hey, out here in our social groups, this is my voice. This is my identity. This is, I need to join this social group or this soul tribe because I have needs that need to get met. This may be an energy that is so wonderful for helping you put your work and your content and yourself out there to make money, right? Even though it is driven by more of this I energy, still, this is like, this placement, Venus becomes unafraid to ask for what she needs. She becomes unafraid with all of this Pisces energy as well to ask for what she needs and as well as to listen to what other people need as well. Now, you're in a very public, deal with others kind of time. This is nothing but delicious for you, okay? On the 9th, we're going to have a full moon happening in the energy of Leo. Now, this is going to light up your third house. All right. Full moon says that something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So we're going to create a shift here. There has to be a change so that something can get kicked back on track and continue its progress forward or put itself down, right? So here in the third house, Leo energy is first of all inventive. It's creative. It's self-expression. Self-expressive. It's got a very big heart. It's laying generosity out there. It's bold, right? This is a big, see me kind of energy. The third house is our thinking, our ideas, the way we communicate, the things that we're studying and learning, what we're writing. Your website exists here in the third house. Siblings are also in this third house as well. So with a full moon in Leo, are you needing to express yourself in some way? Do you need to write? Do you need to record? Do you need to have a conversation about content or something that's important to you? Venus is in Aries. I promise you, you will have something to say. And this moon is going to help you to communicate that. What needs to be adjusted in this area? Have you come in your industry, in your life, in your world? Have you come as far as you can without gathering new information, right? Is this a time where you need to relook at, do I need to study? Do I need to share something? Leo is also not interested in being a copycat, right? So in what you're sharing, in what you're communicating, whether it be business, your home, your own personal journal, this energy wants to see you. Your originality needs to be seen and shining through here. Now, I wouldn't be surprised here either with this full moon if there was like, if maybe you've got some documentation you're taking care of. You know, maybe you're thinking about refinancing that house or something that would acquire some kind of paperwork for you to make a little bit of an adjustment. This could also be a time that this is being kicked off or maybe even brought to a conclusion at that time. Or maybe third house, you've been thinking about it so long that now you realize you're going to take some action on that as well. All right. On the 16th, we've got Mars entering into the energy of Capricorn. So Mars is going to leave that Sagittarian zone, come here in Capricorn, and Mars in Capricorn is the ultimate high five for productivity because Mars is action and energy and he wants to do stuff. He's boots on the ground, right? There's movement happening with Mars. And then he has to get on board and act like a Capricorn, right? Capricorn is structure, is resources, is how do we achieve this? So Mars, all of that energy comes into Capricorn and he's like, hey man, I'm so glad you're here. Let me give you some structure to put all of that energy towards. So Mars and Capricorn are able to achieve here. You're really able to get some things done. Now, where this is lighting up and adding additional firepower to your chart is to this eighth house space. We saw this last month, right? You had a lot happening in this eighth house space. Now you've got a lot more movement to actually get things done, right? And this is producing in the material world, okay? Now, the eighth house is about joint things, joint resources, joint finances. It is also about the most intimate pieces of you, intimacy itself. This could actually be down to sex. Any place where I intimately connect at the closest thing that I have in this life to death, which is fear and freedom, that's what this house is working on, right? So with Mars up here in Capricorn, Capricorn's like, I'm trying to achieve, right? So what you could be working on are things that have to do with death, whether this be the will, the insurance, the taxes, the medical directives, some big kid kind of things. This could be a psychological death. What piece of you, Gemini, and you've been working on this, so this isn't new, what pieces of you psychologically have shifted and have died off so that you can live in another way? Remember, we Phoenix in the eighth house. We die off in one way so that we can live fully and freely in another area. Things I keep thinking about as well, because you do have such a heavy 10th house emphasis. It's like the 8th house and the 10th house get pretty busy this month. One of the things I keep thinking of is if you have products or you're dealing with something that has to do with detoxing, transformation, regeneration, anything like that, these will be things that come up here and you're kind of using this Mars energy to change its direction. I think there's this interesting paradox between pleasure and pain when it comes to dealing with Mars energy and eighth house energy, because sometimes you gotta have a breakdown before you have a breakthrough. You gotta realize what's not right so that you can kick yourself back on course and path to do what's right. The other thing I really do like about this eighth house business we've got going is just looking at this north node down here across the street in Cancer. I do think that, you know, if you've got a spouse who's doing something with money or making financial changes, actually maybe they're making money or you're the one making money at a connection with other people, it does look like you have a fair amount of family support down here to get that done as well. And family is an open word, you know that. It could be your chosen family or maybe it is your biological family. But certainly there's an element of family that's on the table this month, Gemini, as well, okay? All right, then we get to the 17th and we've got Mercury up here in this 10th house coming into its retrograde. Now, Mercury is going to retrograde between your 10th and your 9th houses, Pisces and Aquarian energy, but we are going to start this retrograde here in the energy of Pisces. Now, during a Mercury retrograde, which is your ruling planet or any kind of retrograde, we're going to go back over, review, reconnect, reevaluate, redesign, re-whatever. So, in a career section, or in your, what you do in your very public life, maybe in your work, maybe you're working for someone, this is an opportunity to go back over the mercurial areas, business, communication, study, structure. The 10th house is typically related to Capricorn, so it's very much so about structure here, right? So with Mercury retrograde, you could be going back over any of those things. Mercury will retrograde until March 10th. Now, one of the other things that is kind of coming to me, I'm being shown a house. So I'm not sure whose this is, but since the retrograde is up here in Pisces in the 10th, we also need to consider that down here in the 4th, even though it's not active and you've got stuff going on, what you could be doing is retrograding or going back to a house or a home or something with your family members, and you're going back and you're needing to redo it or to revise it. But the reason you would be doing that would be very Virgo, would be very, let's bring healing, let's bring order, let's get it together, let's perfect this. So I'm not sure who that's exactly pointing at. Let me know if it's you in the comment section down below, but you could be going back to some kind of housing situation. On the 19th, we've got the Sun on the run. The Sun is going to move over here into the energy of Pisces along with Neptune and that retrograde Mercury. Now, where the Sun goes, you are motivated. It brings light, heat, life, vitality. There's movement here. So you are motivated to get these things done. So if you're going back to that house or something in your family, you're motivated. Maybe you even already have the plans on the table to go back to that. But also the Sun here in Pisces may be telling you, hey, Gemini, I need you to reground down in some meditation, right? Like, what do we need for us to be good? What do we need in the solitude space that is inside of us for us to be good? It could go back to, you could be motivated here in this Pisces energy to put out business content that is of spiritual nature or something like that. So wherever it's happening for you, your Piscean energy is lit up by the Sun. There's empathy, there's creativity, there's culmination available with this energy. On the 20th, we've got a cool aspect I want to delve into really quickly. So we've got Jupiter, who's here in the energy of Capricorn in your eighth house. And he's going to come into a sextile with Neptune, who's over here in Pisces in your eighth house, or in your 10th house, excuse me. Now this, you guys, first of all, when the planets have sex, that's good for us, because not only is it a pocket of opportunity, but it's a pocket of opportunity that you will intelligently take action on. So this is a progress forward kind of energy. There's good juju here. Now between your eighth and your 10th houses, if you can see, they're kind of vying for power this month, right? This is very busy, but also the 10th house has got an illumination of energy as well. So these two houses working together give me the idea that more than ever, it is important for you to take action at some kind of joint connection you have, something you feel deeply connected to. Maybe this is you are working with your family business, or you are working in a joint collaboration with someone, and maybe you had to step back to the past, or you've had to step back to a past creative project, idea. Maybe it's the books and the finances, so that you can progress this area forward. Now, the brilliance is from 2018 and all through 2019, we've had this Saturn energy in your eighth house. So you've crystallized some lessons here. You do know how to work in this joint energy. Plus, remember, you've got Mars up there, so your action is moving and you are going. Now, the other thing I think of in this particular energy is, let's say it's your business. You've got to define your ideals here. What are your ideals? What are your principles? What is your mission statement? Whether you have a business or not, what's your life mission statement? What are you doing? If you don't know what your ideals are, how can you know if you're growing into them? If not, you just fall into this place where it's always trying to have balance, always having to dig through your past, and it doesn't feel like a lot of forward motion. Instead, use this energy, define your ideals. Where are you going? Who are you growing into? What do you want your business to look like? What do you want your relationships to look like? And allow this to be a brilliant progression forward for you, okay? On the 23rd, as we end the month, we're going to have a new moon happening right here in the energy of Pisces. Now, the aspect that happens when we have a new moon is the sun and the moon come together, right? And so this is our internal energy and our external energy. And when they come together, anything is possible. Absolutely anything is possible. That's why, even though this is the darkest, calmest phase of the moon, we plant our seeds of intention to begin something fresh here. Not to necessarily begin something new, because you can't just be having a new job every month, right? You can't just have a new financial situation every month. Some things have to grow and you need a fresh perspective on them. So this is where we plant seeds of intention for something fresh to come to our table. And the energy of Pisces, what is this about for you? It's in the 10th house. This could be business. Did you go back to that business that you were working on? Did you go back to a creative project? Did you go back to a company or an organization or a belief even in yourself and who you'd like to be in the world? And now you have this opportunity to go back to it and see if you can bring it forward and share it with the world, right? Is that something maybe you've gone back to? Because if so, you want to plant those seeds of intention here with this beautiful Pisces new moon to allow this to start to blossom and get you moving in the right direction over this next 4 weeks. This is also a wonderful energy for meditation. Is your business meditation? Do you want to bring more meditation into your life in general? Is it prayer? Is it cleaning out, right? This is a wonderful detox energy. Are you cleaning out the body? Are you cleaning out your home? What are you cleaning out and maybe ready to release so that over this next 4 weeks you can have that fresh energy to walk you forward? All right, you guys, I think it's going to be a brilliant month. I hope you enjoy the new board. It's going to continue to get better as I learn about lighting, angles, and all that stuff. So thank you for having some grace with me as we just get it done this month and talk about what's actually happening in the cosmos, because that's what we're here to do. All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you a ton, Geminis, and I look forward to seeing you succeed and supporting you in any way I can. I'll see you next month. Bye.